Ok. Salve. Fine. AS 20, earnings per share. The standard deals with determination and presentation of EPS. I have listened to the few FM class when sir was teaching EPS. So thereby this is not something you should hear as if it is something new topic. This is something already you know. Earnings per share. So generally, general computation was discussed through that topic. From here we are learning the various regulations relating to the computation and the presentation of EPS, earnings per share. This standard requires presentation of two EPS on the face of the P&L. When we say face of the P&L, generally disclosures of accounting standards will be made in the notes. Now this is nothing to do with the information to be presented in the P&L or in the balance sheet. It is not within the P&L or within the balance sheet. So thereby normally people will understand, okay, this is to be computed and will be disclosed means, then people will understand that it will be shown in the notes. It is not in the notes, it will be in the face of the P&L means, after computation of profits in the P&L, below that immediately you will show the information about EPS, basic EPS. Diluted EPS. There are two EPS that has to be presented. So which topic we are discussing? AS 20, earnings per share, which is regulated by accounting standard number 20, computation and presentation of EPS. Shall we proceed? So throughout this topic we are going to learn computation of basic EPS, computation of diluted EPS. Shall we proceed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. We will come back to those pages later. We will continue our discussion. This is not something to come in the examination. Just to tell you that AS 20, what I thought of orally telling, until you settle down, I thought of writing it. It is dealing with determination, computation and presentation of EPS. It requires disclosure of two EPS on the face of P&L. Face of P&L, not in the notes. But when I say face of P&L, it is not in the title. It is not when you write statement of P&L, that time itself you should write EPS, not like that. It is not within the P&L where you will have incomes and expenses. After finding out the PAT, below that you will report the EPS information. Basic EPS, diluted EPS. Shall we proceed? Now, we are proceeding for computation of basic EPS. What is EPS?
Earnings per share.
By the word title that we say, when we spell the word earnings per share, that spelling of the word itself gives us a computation. Earnings per share. How to compute? Earnings by number of shares. Are you following up? So EPS equal to earnings divided by number of shares. Respond pa. Now the term earnings means what? Profit. The term earnings is nothing but profit. Everybody. So basic earnings per share equal to earnings divided by number of shares. Now imagine the term earnings means profit Now you are going to an interview. I am presenting my P&L to you, showing my different levels of profit. Everything is called profit only. Correct? I am showing like this. Profit before interest and tax, 120 lakhs. Interest, 20 lakhs. PBT, 100 lakhs. Tax at 30%. PAT, 70 lakhs. I have various appropriation, friends. General reserve, 15 lakhs. Mandatory reserve, 5 lakhs. Some reserves should be mandatorily created by statute. So statutory reserve, 5 lakhs. Then equity dividend, 20 lakhs. Preference dividend, 10 lakhs. Dividend distribution tax, 3 lakhs. Total, 53 lakhs. Retained profit, retained earnings, 17 lakhs. PBIT, 120. Interest, PBT, 100. Tax, 30. PAT, 70. Appropriation to, transferring from profit to reserve, general reserve, mandatory reserve. Dividend is charge or appropriation? Dividend is charge or appropriation? Both the dividend. Yes, interest only. When I took final accounts, I told you. So then we have dividend distribution tax. Understood? So now that way 53, 70 minus 53. Basic earnings per share equal to? Earnings means profit. Now tell me which number I should take here. Now don't try to explain me anything, this minus that and all. Tell me which number I should take. The numerator. This divided by number of share. So that way EPS is easy computation. You would have already learned number of times in FM. Now tell me which number should I take? 70? 17? 70? 60? இங்கே எழுதிக்கிறேன். 17, 70, 60. EPS 57, 62. Do you understand the question? Pa, question is what is the profit I should take for the purpose of computing EPS? 80, yeah. 50. 20. 20. எதுவும் பிளான் பண்ணலையே. 10, 20, 30. Like that, you are not making me write punishment, correct? I'm asking, sir, biscuit. Enough. Friends, please listen. The question is, what is the earnings I should take? Basic EPS equal to divided by. Now to be very specific, friends, it is the earnings. This is divided by which shares, pa? Equity shares. With the share capital, you should take divide by which shares? Which means this profit should be the profit for the equity shareholders. Correct, pa? Respond. So naturally, this earning should be those earnings which are attributable or available to equity shareholders. Correct? Which is nothing but whether this 120 fully available to equity shareholder?
No.
Because interest should be paid to debentures. 100 is fully available to equity shareholders?
No.
Because 30 rupees paid to government. 70 is fully available to shareholders?
No.
We will see. General reserve fully available to equity shareholders only. Even though it is a statutory reserve, it is available to equity shareholders only because it is a reserve. Equity dividend is fully available to equity shareholders. Preference dividend not available to equity shareholders. So you should have reduced preference dividend as well as dividend distribution tax on preference dividend alone. So thereby your profit has to be 70 minus 10 minus 1, not 3. Because 3 is tax for the entire dividend of 30. Dividend of 30, thereby tax of 3. I will deduct only dividend of 10, and naturally the dividend tax should also be on 10, which is 1. For 30 ki 3 na, 10 ki 1. Understood? So thereby we understand it has to be. Henceforth, let us be very clear, what is this earning, sir? This is actually PAT minus preference dividend minus dividend distribution tax on preference dividends. PAT minus preference dividend minus dividend distribution tax on preference dividend is the computation of earnings. Understood? So it is actually a firm language. We call it as earnings. We call it as profit. Profit attributable to. Henceforth, we call it as PAS. Profit attributable to equity shareholders. Is that clear? So simple. Numerator part is over. Understood? Out of AS 20, we are computing earnings per share computation. Earnings per share, one numerator, one denominator. Say actually a fraction, ratio. Correct? And the numerator part is so easily computed because out of 52 paragraphs, we find only 2-3 paragraphs are relating to earnings. Balance everything relating to denominator. What is denominator? Number of shares. This standard, the same standard, is the first chapter we are going to take in final level. We will start with earnings only. Understood? So, but that will be taken around 9 to 10 hours will be taking at final level, the same topic. Here it is not an advanced level of learning of EPS, just elementaries of computation of EPS. Correct, Abba? Respond. So don't worry about the standard. When you read the text and all, that is unnecessary. Same text only common for IPCC or final. Standard is applicable, but only basics applicable, not advanced. This is small. Now proceeding. So thereby earnings attributable to or profit attributable to equity shareholders, which is equal to dash minus dash minus dash. Profit after tax minus preference dividend minus dividend distribution tax on preference dividend, not on equity dividend. Understood? Please respond. Okay. So earnings over. Earnings over? Okay, pa. Next comes, sir, denominator part. What is denominator, sir? Number of equity shares. Is that clear to you, sir? So what is the numerator? PAS. Profit attributable to equity, which is equal to PAT minus. PAT minus. Preference dividend minus. Dividend distribution tax on preference dividend. That's all. Clear? Pakka? Thereby, in this example, it is 70 minus 10 minus 1. Answer is 59. Understood? So, answer has to be 59. Understood? Profit available to equity shareholders is called 59. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Shall we? Denominator what? Number of equity shares. Right? One for 2013, the company was having 1 lakh shares. Numbers. Everybody? 31st July 2013, additional issue 60,000 shares. How many shares? 1 to 2014, one more issue, 30,000 shares. Right? 31st March 2014, total number of shares is 1 lakh plus 60 plus 30, 1,90,000 shares. Opening, closing. Now when I say EPS, it is earnings per
share.
Is it an information about a particular date or is it an information about a period? Is it a period information or a date information? Point information or period information?
Period
information. It is not performance of a date. It's a performance for a
period.
Correct, Appa? Respond. So EPS, though computed on a particular date, but it's a information for a
period.
Understood? Appo, profit is arrived for the year 13-14. 59 lakhs. How much? Now only we know. Respond, Ba. Now, divided by number of shares in a given. Which number of shares, sir? Opening or closing? Opening or closing? For the year, which year we are computing? Is it computation for a period or date? Hari?
Period.
So, which share I should take? 1 lakh or 190?
Average.
Everybody, we should not take opening. We should not take closing. We should take what average, sir? Simple average, illa weighted average. Are you following this? We should be taking number of equity shares. What number of equity shares? Weighted average number of equity shares. There were times I used to spend only 1 hour to just give the basics and all. I will take minimum 2 or 15 minutes and all for this standard, because every examination I find a definite 4-mark question. But simple area, if you invest time, that 4 marks definitely you can pocket it. And 4 marks will really change, sir. With the 2 or 3 hours preparation, the 4 marks in a subject is over now. That is very good one thing. Understood? So that way, please do attend, sir. These are the areas. Without much complication, you can easily fetch marks. In the class only, preparation can be completed. Understood, Abba? Simple mathematics only we are going to perform. So we are going to take what, Ba? So it is not merely number of shares. Now I am changing this. It is actually weighted average number of equity shares. We call it as VANs. Understood? So now EPS, basic EPS equal to PES divided by VANs. What is that PES? Profit attributable to equity shareholders divided by weighted average number of equity shares. Sir, you said weighted average, sir. But how to compute weighted average? Why it is weighted average is easily understandable, because shares are employed in that business. Shares generated profit for different period. 1 lakh shares earned profit for 12 months. 60,000 shares earned profit only for the shares existing during that period. So like that, different shares earned profit for different period. Please respond. And when you want to take one common number, naturally it has to be weighted average number of shares. What sort of weight means? That period weight. Everybody. So what is that period weight? Shall we? It is not like profit multiplied by 1, 2, 3, 4 and all. It's a period weight. So how to find out VANs? VANs is very simple computation. 1 lakh was there for 12 months in that year. No, 12 by 12. Not merely 12, it is 12 by 12. It is 1 lakh. 60,000 shares was issued on 31st July. So in that year 13-14, how many months it was there? It is how many months? 8 months. 40,000? Then we have 30,000 shares into how many months is this 30,000 shares existing? 2 months. 5,000? So thereby it is 1,45,000 is the number of shares we should consider. Understood, Abba? Simple computation, that number of shares into weight. What is that weight? period weight. Number of months by 12. What is the number of months? Number of months outstanding by 12. What is the number of months outstanding from opening date to the issue date? Illa. Issue date to the end of the year. Are you following? What is the number of months pa? Opening date to issue date? Adhi illa sir. Issue date to the end of the year. Could you appreciate that? So issue took place on 31st? Issue took place on 31st? July. Understood? So issue took place on 31st. So thereby it should be from 31st July to the end of the year. Understood? So 31st July to the end of the year. Everybody? Is that clear to you? Fine. So similarly, the third category of share, first February to the end of the year, February and March. Could you appreciate?
Yes, sir.
So thereby we find that Vane's weighted average number of equity shares, weighted average number of equity shares equal to the number of shares into period weight. Period weight equal to number of months outstanding by 12. In practice, so suddenly people start asking questions, what if middle of the year and all. So in practice, it is actually number of days by 365. But in examination, there is no concept of number of days and all, because we never want to test the arithmetical accuracy of the concept. The concept is that this is the weight you should consider. Correct, Appa? So Arbha, you will not be given with the number of days and all. If it is happening in between the month and all, it has to be number of days and not number of months. Could you appreciate that? Everybody. So thereby we learn for academic purpose, it is only number of months by 12. Is that clear? Number of months mean what day to what date? Issue date to the end of the year. Clear? Everybody? Pakka? Okay. Now this can also be computed in another way. This can be computed the other way. How na? 1 lakh was there as 1 lakh. Up to 31st July, friends. Because from 31st July, it become 160. But what you could have done, you could do cumulative effect. 1 lakh into 4 by 12. Please respond, friends.
Yes,
after 4 months in this year, it become 160. Yeah?
Yes,
it became
160.
160 was there from 31st July to 12. Correct? For a period of 6 months, 160,000 into 6 by 12 plus 160 became 1,90,000 was there for 2 months. If you do like this also, you will get what? 1,45,000. Either individual transaction to the end of the year or transaction to transaction approach. So there are two ways you can compute. So either transaction to transaction, but sometimes this may confuse you. So thereby we don't follow this particular method. We always follow what? Transaction to year ending date. Each transaction separately to the year ending date. Please respond.
Yes, sir.
Similarly, suppose if there is any reduction happen, the reduction will be taken as negative numbers, my dear friends. Negative number into the period outstanding. Are you following? So if there is any buyback of 10,000 share on 1st of March, on 1st of
March,
if there is any
buyback,
I would have taken 10,000 minus 10,000 into 1 by 12.
Yes,
minus 10,000 into? And I will be considering that many shares as minus, you will be getting weights.
Yes, sir.
Understood? So like that, we will be computing weighted. We have already learned now both the parts. What are the both the parts? Profit. What is the profit? Earnings available to equity shareholders. Profit available to equity shareholders equal to PAT minus preference dividend minus dividend distribution tax on preference dividend. Denominator, weighted average number of equity shares equal to number of shares into period weight, which is the number of months outstanding from issue date to the year ending date. That's all. Simple, clear.
Yes, sir.
Okay. There is another weight that we may consider, which is called a paid up value weight. Another weight that we are considering is called a, what is that, sir? Suppose this is of rupees 10 fully paid up. Examples pa. Not necessary you should write, please understand the computation. We got plenty of questions again to solve only. So of rupees 10 fully paid. Of rupees 10, rupees 7 paid up. Of rupees 10, rupees 5 paid up. Everybody, respond. Like that, different shares are different amount paid up. In that case, we will work out this number of shares as mains equal to, how will you work out now? 1 lakh into 12 by 12 into 10 by 10. Correct? Out of the total face value, what is the amount paid up? So thereby it is 1 lakh. 1 lakh into 12 by 12 into 10 by 10. Next, 60,000 into 8 by 12 into 7 by 10. 10 rupees is 7 paid up. Now 7 by 10. Manikanda. Next, 30,000 into 2 by 12 into 5 by 10. Like that, you should compute mains. 2,000. 1 lakh. 30,500. Are you following? So, because when you have first computation, we presume all the shares are fully paid. In this computation, we find that some shares are fully paid, some shares are partly paid. That two different amounts. So you'll apply different weights. Correct? So there are two weights you are multiplying. What are the two weights? Period weight, then paid up value weights. What are the two weights, my dear? And paid up value weight. Period weight means number of months outstanding by 12. Period weight means number of months outstanding by 12. Number of months outstanding by 12. What is the number of months that is correct from the date of issue to the end of the year? Super. Everybody. Now paid up value weight means amount paid up divided by face value. That's all. Not issue price. Never issue price. Out of face value, how much is paid? Everybody? Pakka? So that is how we are just computing. Two weights are there. Because like the detail you don't learn in FM. So various computational issues are regulated by AS20. Correct? So thereby in computation of weighted average number of equity share. Because in that we are not going to focus much about EPS. EPS is a tool there we are applying. Correct? There number of shares only one amount is given. But here different issues given, different paid up value given, you should know how which number I should take. Now, you should take weighted average number of share considering two weights. One is called a period weight, the other one is called a paid up value weight. Understood, Abba? Everybody, pakka?
Yes,
shall we proceed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, so we are taking AS, this standard dealing with the computation and presentation of EPS. Two EPS to be presented, basic EPS, diluted EPS. We are initially focusing only on basic EPS. We discuss blah blah information. It is paid by Vance. Profit attributable to equity shareholders divided by weighted average number of equity shares. Pays equal to PAT minus preference dividend minus dividend distribution tax on preference dividend. Vains. Number of shares into period weight into paid value weights. That's all. Simple. Everybody? Pakka? Okay. Question number 1, page number 43. No. Find out. 143, roll number. Find out weighted average number of equity shares from the following information. No much time, my dear friends. We don't have much agenda today. Only completion of this standard. Totally 11 questions only. Okay, wow. We are spending maximum time on the accounting standards. When we are spending time, please make utilize of that. Let us not waste much of time. There are so many problems to be read. See, branch account, department account, like that. So many questions will come. Now let us quickly complete. 31st August 2014. Additional shares issued for cash 600. 1st February 2015. 1st February 2015. Buyback of shares 300. All the shares have equal rights and are fully paid. The rights issue made never had any bonus element. There is some importance for these lines, but nothing to do with our computation of this question. What is the significance? I will tell you later. When I discuss something about bonus element is something is there in the standard bar. That's more. So, to avoid confusion, they are very clearly giving you information that there is no bonus element in this question. This question does not have. If there is bonus element, you should compute the weighted average number of shares in a different way. So, what is a different way? What is bonus element? We will discuss. In this question, bonus element not there given. Correct? Respond. Normal computation. Taka taka tell. 20? 2100. 2100. Question number 1. Vane's equal to. If you go by a presentation, friends, date. Particulars, number of shares, weight, veins, 1/4/2014, opening balance, 1800, 12 by 12, 1800. 31st August 2014, additional issue 600, 300, that's very nice. Everybody, so in this question, unfortunately, closing balance of number of shares and veins happening to be same. You don't doing shortcut, sir. Why you do all computation? 1800 plus 600 minus 300 answer, sir. Either don't tell. Understood? So all our workings don't make it as a waste and all. That is just incidentally matching. Don't bring out such shortcut. This is how we'll be computing veins. This 2100, right? If you have a different paid up value, then you will add one more weight. Weight under that period weight, paid up value. Two weights you will multiply. Correct? Question number 3. 60 seconds. Now question number 3. Correct. Can I turn this page? So date 1/4/2013, opening balance 1800, 12 by 12, 10 by 10, 1800. 31st Jan 14. Additional issue, rights issue. You know what is rights issue? Existing shareholders. Whether the outsiders are existing shareholders, it's an issue, new issue. 1000? Okay. 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 80. That's okay. 1880. For that purpose only, this dividend is asked. Now friends, please listen. In this question, we are computing Vane says 1880. There is one more question which is asked you for computation of dividend. Now listen friends. The question is computation of dividend. Listen here. The dividend is usually computed like this. You have opening number of shares being 1800 into rupees 10, because we know that dividend is computed on face value, that too on paid up share capital on proportionately as per AOA, correct? Table A provision. 1800 into rupees 10 into rate 5% into 12 by 12 900. Respond. Then 1200 into 4 rupees na paid at 5% for only 2 months 40. So dividend is 940, correct? Now why in this question they are asking you dividend computation? Like this proportionate computation, so in many steps can be avoided by directly computing the dividend like this. 1880 into 10 into 5%. So with the help of Vane's, you can directly compute proportionate dividend is what this problem wants to teach you. Understood? So that is, with the help of Vane's, you can compute the proportionate dividend directly is what we are going to learn from this particular question. Thereby only 1880 into 10 rupees 10 into 5% 940. That is why they asked you computation of dividend in this question. Correct? And cross verified with the answer 940 in a normal computation without computation of Vane's. Everybody, are you following? Okay, can I turn this page? Can I take the previous page? Yes sir, no sir, then whom sir? So I am coming from final class, so morning itself class. If I want to wear dhoti, it will take half an hour. Now please sir, can I turn the next previous page? On farewell I will wear sir, I will wear lungi sir. No, no. Okay. Sariya. Pona. Huh? நான் வந்து can I turn this page friends? Question number 4, page number 44. Friends, please stop talking. The issued and fully paid share capital of a company as on 1/4/2013. Comprised 4 lakhs 7% preference shares of rupee 1, 4 lakhs. 30 lakhs equity share of rupee 1, 30 lakhs. Totally 34 lakhs. On 1st of December 2014, a further 6 lakh equity shares were issued and fully paid in cash. Profit for the financial year ending 31st March 2014 was 19,76,000 after tax. The company has to pay dividend tax at 10.2%. Find out basic EPS. Find out basic EPS. Is quickly try and tell me the basic EPS. Ah, chicken ella minor da. Chain and all minor. Not chain, no. Chain is minor. Ayyo. Full should be made, not merely this much. You make it full. Like RSN. RSN should come up to this. Farewell. See, 3% are there. What's the answer? So, 0.61. 0.49. 2 decimals. Paisepa. Adala poi. 0.50. 50 paise. 0.4. 0.6. 0.61. Friends, please listen. It is first computation is base. Correct? Profit after tax 19,76,000 minus preference dividend 4 lakhs into 7% 28,000 dividend distribution tax 10.2% on dividend 28,000 2,000, so thereby 30,856, 19,45,000 144. Next, veins. Veins is very simple. It is 30 lakhs into 12 by 12 plus 6 lakhs into 4 by 12. Correct? Na? 30 lakhs was there throughout the year. 6 lakhs was there only for 4 months. December, January, February, March. Apo 32 lakhs. So basic EPS equal to 0.1 by 0.2. It is 0.61. That's very good. Your doubts, please, if you have any. If there is any doubts, friend, please listen. Pay is equal to PAT minus preference dividend minus dividend distribution tax on preference dividend. Veins equal to during the year whatever number of share existing. So you should work out opening number of share into 12 by 12 plus current year issue into the remaining period by 12. Any doubts that you have, please do raise. Everybody? Can I turn this page? Yes. Okay. Can I turn this page? Sure, Chandan, leave. Friends, please stop talking. Veins equal to weighted average number of equity shares equal to number of shares into weights. What are the weights? Period weight, paid up value weight. Paid up value weight. Amount paid up divided by face value. Period weights. Number of months outstanding divided by 12. Number of months outstanding. Issue date to the year ending date. Shares are issued by a company. For what purpose? To raise money. But not only for getting cash. Not for getting only dudde. It is for getting assets. It is for getting some services. It is settlement of a loan. It is issued to promoters. It is given as bonus. It is issued for the selling company as purchase consideration. It can be given for amalgamation nature of merger, redemption of debentures, conversions, ESOP, like that. Shares are issued for different purpose. The standard says that at all times you can't take from the date of issue. You may take some other date, but we have to take some other date. I'll tell you the ultimate objective behind that date. The standard feels it, though it is not given expressively. It is given for different issue, different date. Ultimate objective is that you are issuing shares for getting some benefit. Respond. Either it may be tangible or may not be tangible. It may be for some services you got from some AMC service, you giving shares. Respond. So it may be for getting some assets or services whatsoever. Ultimately, the date should be counted from the date of getting services, from the date of getting benefits, not from the date of issue. For example, I buy one asset on 1st of July 2014. I buy one asset on 1st of July 2014. But to the vendor, the consideration which will be agreed was to be discharged in shares. But I issued the share only on 1st of August. It is not like a paper, sir. Immediately I am buying shares. Now take this page. Like a ticket I can't give. Are you following? Shares issue has got a lot of legal formalities. Compliances has to be made. Correct, Abba? So I got the asset on 1st of July. But I am issuing the shares on. Then the standard says that the number of months to be counted not from 1st August but from 1st July. That's a concept. Following up. So that way we have some other date to be considered for the purpose of veins. We don't take from the issue date, we take from some other date. We call that date as effective date. Are you following this? So thereby now we like to take effective date. Understood? So wait, that is period wait should be considered from effective date and not from issue date. Now let us discuss what and all effective date. Shares issued effective date. When the shares are issued for cash, effective date is the date on which cash is receivable. Date on which cash is receivable and not the date on which you have issued the shares. Okay. Shares issued for services. Date on which services rendered. Date on which services rendered. Then shares issued for purchase of asset. Then effective date is what? Date of purchase of asset. Not from the date of issuing the shares. It's actually from the date of purchase of asset. Shares issued for conversion of debt. Date of conversion. Shares issued for conversion of debt. Then date of? What is this, sir? Effective date for what purpose? From which date I should consider for the purpose of? Period weight. Weighted average. Correct? Okay. Can I? Okay. Shares issued for amalgamation in the nature of purchase. Date of amalgamation. Shares issued for amalgamation in the nature of merger. Date of first date of the current reporting period bonus issue, shares issued free without any consideration. First day of the previous reporting period. First day of the previous reporting period. Friends, please listen. See, amalgamation taking place on 1st June 2013. Shares issued on or 1st February 2014. Shares issued on 1st March 2014. Amalgamation took place on 1st February 2014. Shares issued on 1st March 2014. Now tell me, what is the effective date here? If the amalgamation is in the nature of purchase, then it is 1-2-2014. If the amalgamation is in the nature of merger, then 1st April 2013, not both the dates, some other date. 1st April of 2013, that is current year 13-14, na? First day of current reporting period. Respond, pa. Why is it like that? It is because in merger, the purchasing company will not only take the assets and liability but also the reserves and surplus including the profits earned by the selling company from the beginning of the year till the acquisition date. See, purchasing company can also take the profits of in case of merger. Apo 13-14 profit of purchasing company will have not only profits of purchasing company but also the profits of selling company. Understood? But the profits of 13-14 of purchasing company will also have profits of selling company. So if the numerator is going to have profits right from 1st April, then naturally denominator also should be considered as if outstanding from first day of current reporting. This is the logic, nowhere explained, please try to understand that. Are you following? Otherwise simply a rule. What is that? Shares issued for amalgamation in the nature of merger means first day of the current reporting. That's a rule. If it is in the nature of purchase means date of amalgamation. But both the cases not from the date of issue. Not from the date of issue. So originally what I taught you, now it is replaced. I told that it is from the issue date to the year ending date. Now I am changing that. I am calling it as effective date to the year ending date. Is that clear? Bonus issue. First day of the That is, suppose bonus issue was made on, bonus issue was made on 1st February 2014. Then it should be considered as if it is outstanding from 1st April 2012. Not 13. Current year is 13, 14. Everybody, previous year is 12, 13. But it is outstanding from 1-4-2012. Why? Later. Understood why in it? We will be discussing later. Shall we? Everybody, now presently you understand other provisions only. Right? Everybody. Friends, when I issue the bonus on 1st of February 2000, it is considered outstanding from 1st April 2012. Now when I work out EPS for the year 13-14, bonus imagine was 50,000 shares. Bonus was? I should consider this 50,000 outstanding for how many months, pa? Tell me. For the year 13-14, pa, how many months it is to be considered as outstanding? Even though effective date is 1-4-2012, please respond. If you take from that date till this now, it is 24 months. Sir. So you should not say it is outstanding for 24 months. When I work out EPS for the current year, it is outstanding only for 12 months. Understood? Even though effective date is 1st of April 2012, for the 13-14 EPS, it is there only for 12 months. But do you rework the EPS of previous year, sir? Maybe, I don't know. Understood? We will discuss later. Shall we? So presently we understand that the effective date is 1-4-2012. But current year EPS we should take only? You issue bonus on any day, sir. It is outstanding for 12 months in the current year. Even the bonus issued on the last day, sir, bonus is considered outstanding for 12 months. Respond, pa. Everybody? Okay. Now listen, question number 2. Please try question number 2. I don't know. Okay. Date 1st April 2013. Opening balance. Numbers 9000. Friends, please stop talking. Effective date is 1-4-2013. 12 by 12. 9000. 1st July 2013, you have issued shares. Rights issue. Rights issue. 1 for 3. 3,000. 1-7-2013 only. 9 months. 2250. 1-10-2013. This is the issue date. As for the purpose of asset purchased. How many shares? Once again, 3,000. Effective date is 1-5-2013. Even though shares was issued on 1-10-2013, effective date to be considered as 1-5-2013. Correct, Appa? Respond. 11 months. 2750. 31st October 2013. Amalgamation, the nature of merger. 4,500.
First April 2013.
12 by 12, 4,500. Then February 1, 2014, amalgamation in the nature of purchase. How many? 1,200. February 1, 2014, 200. 18? 18,700.